Oh yeah, Tuesday. I'm Coach Skip and I have your burn at home workout for Tuesday from Wildfire Fitness. So it is a beautiful morning out. So it is a great time, whether it's, you know, morning, noon, or evening, to get a great workout in, get a sweat going, and to feel better about yourself. And by getting that going, you will increase your confidence, you will get the blood flowing, and you will feel a whole lot better. Better yet, if you string it together and get a few days in a row, or at least three or four times a week, you're going to be feeling good in no time. And we're always here to help. Give us a call. Come on in. Send us an email. Whatever you need to do. So getting after it today. We've got a warm up with three rounds. We're going to be doing 20 jumping jacks, 10 good mornings, 20 flutter kicks, and then 10 plank shoulder taps. So starting with those jumping jacks, just getting everything moving together, arms and legs, get that agility and coordination going. If you want to make it a little bit more intense, then clap above and behind the back every single time. If you need to bring down the intensity, then just step back and forth here and just get the best range of motion possible. Even if you're only going up halfway, that's okay. Or if you're jumping and not getting the legs out, that's what we're looking for. After that, we're going to get a little stretch with 10 good mornings. So bend at the waist. Notice the soft bend in the knees. That way I can really isolate my hamstrings up into my glutes and get this good stretch here every time. After your 10 good mornings, and if you need to do that holding on to something just for a little bit more balance, that's okay too. Then we've got flutter kicks. So you're going to be flat on your back, hands out by the sides. Kick those feet, small little kicks here. Keep that flutter going. If you need to put your hands underneath your hips, this will just help you stabilize your hips a little bit more. And if you need to do this from a seated position instead of getting down on the ground, that's okay too, right in here. Last one is going to be plank shoulder tap. So you're going to be on your hands and toes. Keep that torso straight and just reach up, right arm to left shoulder, left arm to right shoulder. And just back and forth, right plus left equals one on these. If you need to do this off your knees, right in here, or you can even use your platform. The higher the platform, the less the resistance. That's okay too. So three rounds, 20 jumping jacks, 10 good mornings, 20 flutter kicks, and then 10 plank shoulder taps. After that, get any stretching you need in, grab a sip of water, get ready to go for the warm up. We've got a 15 minute AMRAP for the workout today. We're going to be doing as many rounds as possible in 15 minutes of 15 air squats, 10 sit-ups, 15 mountain climbers, 10 push-ups, and then 15 plank jacks. So we're just working back and forth between 15 and 10 reps on each different exercise. We're starting, again, set that clock for 15 minutes or start it, you know, with a time on any kind of a clock. Counting and getting that time frame in will help with the intensity level. By keeping that 15 minutes of time, you can keep a good pace going for the entire 15 minutes. We're going to be doing air squats first. So feet about shoulder width apart, push those hips back and down, keep that chest up, and stand up all the way at the end of each one. By getting my arms out, this is just going to help counterbalance. Make sure you're staying on your heels and really work on getting that hip crease below parallel and keep that back flat as you're going down. If you need to do this holding onto something, again, this is just going to decrease the resistance as you're standing up. As soon as you can, just let go. So that way you're using your muscles instead of holding on with your upper body. Or do it from a seated position where you're sitting down and standing up every single time for those air squats. Get as low as you can. If you need to stay a little bit higher because your knees or your hips, that's fine. Tomorrow, you'll get a little bit better range of motion. After your 15 air squats, we've got 10 sit-ups. So legs either straight out in front of you or butterflied. You're going all the way back, shoulders touching the ground, and throw those arms forward every single time. If you need to hold on to something, grab something that weighs 3 to 5 pounds, and this will help give you some momentum as you throw that forward, and it'll help you get up to the top. You could also do this from a seated position where you're just bringing your knees into your chest and letting it go. So those are your sit-ups. The next one is gonna be mountain climbers. So on your hands and just bringing your knees to your elbows and just alternating. Again, right plus left equals one. Back and forth here, or do stepping. You can also do this from a raised position, either the jumping or the stepping. And just bring that foot up to meet the hand or the bench. After your mountain climbers, you're gonna be doing push-ups. On the push-ups, hands right underneath the shoulders, going all the way down, chest touching the ground. Notice how my elbows are going behind me. And then as I push away, driving both my hips and chest away from the ground at the same time. If you need to go off your knees here, that's okay. Or doing it from that raised platform, the front of a couch or a chair, even a countertop from a standing position to get that range of motion. I'm looking for more range of motion than I am doing a strict push-up. That by using that full extent of the muscles, we're gonna get nice, long, lean muscles instead of that pump. The more you're shortening it, the more you're gonna limit your range of motion and your flexibility. So after your 10 push-ups, you're gonna be going back up to 15 plank jacks from your forearms here, and you're just going back and forth right in here. You could also do this from your hands. And if you need to go step out and back, that's okay too. Or from that raised platform, both of them, either jumping or stepping. Again, really keep that torso as straight as possible through this exercise. So 15 minutes, as many rounds as possible of 15 air squats, 10 sit-ups, 15 mountain climbers, 10 push-ups, and then 15 plank jacks. So have fun, go hard, go fast, get as many rounds as you possibly can in that 15 minutes. At the end of your first round, take a look at the clock and work on keeping that pace for the entire way and then speeding it up in the last 2 to 3 minutes of the workout. So have fun with this one, guys. Share it with somebody that you know and love that you want to see get in shape and get fit. So thanks a lot. Have a great day, and we'll talk to you soon.